Welcome back, guys. It's Vengeance Hero, and you are joining me for Alan Wake Remastered, and this is going to be our first episode of the DLC. So in my last episode, which was the final episode of the main game, I mentioned that I wasn't sure how to access the DLC, so I did a little bit of digging, and it turns out that it is just in here. Which I almost wanted to try that, but I didn't. I don't know. My brain was telling me to try that, and I just decided that I would go and look into it on my own. So this is going to be episode one of the DLC, The Signal. This is the first DLC.
And previously on Alan Wake,
do a quick catch up.
Something I only know is the dark presence held my wife captive and used her to make me write a horror story that came true.
I'll bring her back.
Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story. I saved Alice, then wrote a better ending for the story. But not without a price. I was trapped somewhere in the dark place, a strange zone.
Ah, that's right.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean.
That's right. We're trapped in the darkness. We wrote ourselves into the darkness to save her.
After the completion of any difficult undertaking, there are mixed emotions. Accomplishment and relief. Sadness, depression. For a while, everything was about the work. Like an illness, it consumed you, changed you. You locked yourself away from the world to do it, and now you need to recover, learn to live without it, find a way to crack open the door, and let the light back in.
So we are stuck in a different version of the town.
It was familiar, but wrong somehow.
Welcome to the...
Oh, God.
Everything had a surreal, dreamlike quality.
I can't believe it.
I had a disturbing feeling of deja vu. I had no idea why I was here or where I had been before this moment. But something was waiting for me at the back of the diner.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in
love. Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now.
God. So each of the DLCs is about 2 hours long, I believe. Investigate the restroom. The men's restroom, I suppose. Hello? Weird.
Alan, listen to me. Go no deeper.
What?
Focus. You're losing yourself. I will try to help the best I can, but it's up to you. Find a better point of contact.
What do you mean?
I cannot hear you. Please, you're the one making all this happen. Concentrate. This is what's happening.
Nightmares. Too deep. Can't take the pressure. It's too much.
Suddenly, Wake found himself face to face.
Jesus, we're losing it.
At the sight of myself, the dream suddenly became lucid. The dark place. That's where I was.
You will need weapons.
Ooh, give me that flashlight. Yeah, boy.
It's not the light itself, but what it represents. You will need it.
Oh, and a pistol too?
This is not a gun. It is a tool in a logical process of elimination. Be careful. I will try to find a better point of contact.
I didn't understand Zane's message, and knowing where I was didn't fix anything. Something had gone wrong after I had finished departure.
Oh, okay. You are gonna open. This is not a gun. It's a tool in the process of elimination. That's one way of...
The diner had become deserted. Then the door was smashed off his hinges.
Oh, shit. That's what's gonna happen right now.
Get your punch box.
You're in the way, my dude. Back this way. Gotta grab the goodies back here. Okay, so there's gonna be more alarm clocks in the DLC as well.
Zane! Wait for me!
Wait, homie.
The world had become twisted. These trees didn't belong.
We don't have much ammo. We're making a run for it. Did that work? Sort of. Shit, that was intense. More ammo. Ow, we need more ammo. More manuscript pages.
I knew it was my writing, but the words were jumbled to dreamlike fragments. Reloading frantically, the rounds of slippery stone was thrown away from the tent. The bed looked inviting, but it was just the radio. She was startled by the phone. GPS system was working. I hadn't expected that.
Who that calling? They calling me.
Hello?
I'm trying to reach you. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Listen, I can help you, but you're drifting deeper. I can't reach you. You must come to me. I can't maintain the connection. Use the words. Follow the signal.
It made no sense for the GPS system to work. I doubted any satellite was in range here. These were alien skies, but it was guiding me towards something. Towards Zane?
Can't go there. Okay, where are we supposed to go then? Just back out the front door? Oh, we can't go back out the front door. Oh, nice.
Something had shifted again. The dark place was playing tricks on me. It wouldn't stay still.
The town itself turned against Wake. Cars flew toward him. It cracked bone and crushed muscle. It oozed hate.
Oh, God. So many. Fuck. Aye. Just crushed my fucking head for sure.
Something had shifted again. The dark place was playing tricks on me. It wouldn't.
I just run away.
The town itself turned against Wake. Cars flew
toward him. I think I'm just gonna run for it. Oh shit. Oh my God. Whatever, we're cheesing him. Oh God. Yikes, man. There's a lot of fucking guys in here. Not enjoying this right now.
Everything I saw was familiar, and yet it wasn't.
Hello.
I cannot keep up. You're going too deep. I will try to guide you. Follow the signal.
I'm trying.
You must face yourself. Follow me.
What is this? Odin Anderson.
The GPS system was supposed to lead me to Zane, but the shifts were interfering with it. I had to keep trying. I wouldn't survive alone.
Odin Anderson, the Allfather, the trickiest geriatric with the wittiest gimmick, the deranged patriarch with a trademark tangent, crazy like a fox, dig? The enduringly popular star of the hit reality series Barry Wheeler presents new tricks for old gods, blasts out his latest masterpiece guaranteed to please gourmands everywhere. Moonshine, It's What's for Dinner is available at in all fine bookstores, also available as a modestly priced limited edition with annotations and commentary by Barry Wheeler. Lem fans, take note, coming soon as an audiobook. Okay.
Changes were becoming more violent. The street wasn't so much ripped apart as it was missing. Like some great hand had reached out and scooped it. Now erratic, unstable.
Oh, it's fucking rolling off the edge. Beautiful. Sarah Breaker. Great Falls Finest, the red-hot cop chick with the lightning-fast boomstick. Her debut book, The Only Girl in the Bookhouse, delves deep into the double life of having a successful law enforcement career while being involved in a secret society. How does Daddy's Little Trooper fit into an old-fashioned fraternity? Hmm. Well, my flashbang rolled off the edge of the fucking street, so that's terrible. What's this over here? Batteries?
Thank you.
brother. Okay, bro. Ooh. Man, I'm really gonna have to use all my resources here. Holy shit. Luckily, I've got another couple of flares that'll help.
Allie!
Where are you? Look, I'm trying to follow your goddamn signal.
The dark place is playing tricks on you. You're still going deep. I'm trying to guide you, but it's hard.
What is this?
I can help you if you just stop sinking.
What? This is bullshit.
It's happening again. Brace yourself.
I was running after Zane, and he was telling me I was going too deep. It was ridiculous, but I was more scared than amused. I felt like I was being hidden by an unseen force and brings light.
What? What the? Big boy shotgun. Yeah, we're really, just over there. Nothing. We're really having to fight to survive here. Flares.
I don't see Barry.
Barry.
Look, wait, maybe that's him. That's the way to the chopper.
I remembered this. This happened before we found Barry.
Was a little bit scary. Concealed firearms. Jesus.
I had to find the key to get the door open.
Oh God. I dodged. I guess it was a giant semi-truck, so... Alright, well I have no... No flares.
I had to find the key to get the door open.
Shit, man. Oh God. Yeah. Over here. Lithium batteries.
The world was... It was changing. Twisting out of control. It was too big on the inside. He couldn't see the sea. Something was moving. He was lost. He couldn't find the exit.
The shifts were getting more severe. I wasn't sure if the place got bigger. The signal was going haywire. I would have to find my way out of here on my own.
Okay, I think we can use these to our advantage. We don't fucking set ourselves on fire here. Oh God. That's what's up, bitches. I will fucking set you on fire. Don't test me. Bro. Holy shit, man. One guy still over here somewhere? Guess not. phone over here. There's an alarm clock. I don't think we're gonna find all of them. Like 2 of 10.
Zane left me a page. He was trying to help me.
I'm a figment of your imagination, just like pretty much everything else you see here. Maybe even you.
That's insane.
Yeah, you're right. Everything that happened before made perfect sense, but this is insane. Good catch, Al.
Okay. Okay, look, I gotta get going. The GPS...
GPS, yeah, I know. Follow the signal. Got it. So, anywho, I'm here to help you. Thing is, you need to get a grip, all right?
You nag the way the real Barry does, you know that?
Well, hey, you know, be fair. It's not my fault you think I'm annoying.
I don't think you're annoying.
Ah, baby, relax, it's cool. Just try to stay on the ball here. You need to do what Zane tells you. He's been here for ages. He's like the expert.
Okay. I'm listening. Doing all the things.
Anyway, if this is insane, and it's all from your mind, what's that say about you?
I think the signal's pointing towards that thing in the distance.
Yeah, that'd be the Biltmore sawmill.
How the hell do you know that?
I don't know anything you don't. So why don't you ask yourself that? Huh? Maybe you saw a sign for it back in the real world. Or maybe it's the sawmill, because I said it. Mama! And you have...
If you complete that sentence, you're fired.
Mightier than the sword.
You're fired.
Aww.
You're fired, Barry. We are using all the traps they give us. Still sad about my flashbang rolling off the edge of the cliff.
Not even flesh anymore. Just shadows and ghosts and thoughts slicing through his flesh.
Oh. Oh God. God. Getting turned around here. Gotcha.
You know, you're gonna have to get way across here. I'm thinking the solution probably has something to do with those words.
Really? You think?
Yeah! You should probably use them.
Your insight is staggering.
Oh, I know.
Perfect.
Ah, see, this is the way things should be. I give advice, and you follow. That's when things go right. Get up to something.
Are you sure about that, man?
That's horseshit.
Cynthia Weaver.
Well, I'm not saying anything you haven't come up with first. Big Mint, remember?
This kind of thing could drive a man insane.
Cynthia Weaver.
No! This is great! And it's probably therapeutic for you, too.
The Lady of the Light, the Cloud of Gloom, and the Well-Lit Room. Weaver's difficult and uncompromising life is illuminated in Cynthia Weaver, carrying the torch, an enlightening and occasionally harrowing biography by Ellen Adams, who's an intern at the Bright Falls Record under Weaver's editorship. Oh. No! The shit is falling off the edge.
Wake's own words, littering the landscape. His books, common and dispersed, like mud beneath his feet, hardbacks.
God.
I had seen weird transmissions of myself before, but not like this. The voices I saw now sounded insane, like a demented storyteller who was out to torment and destroy his protagonist.
Get off me!
Okay. We gotta try and get through here without... Can't use flares, otherwise I'm gonna screw myself. Oh God. No more ravens. We're touching any of that shit. What? Oh God. What? What is... what even happened? Oh, for fuck's sakes.
But not like this. The version...
That's really annoying.
Out to torment and destroy his protagonist.
Get off!
Oh, I almost jumped off the edge there.
Al, come on! You gotta be careful! It's a bad
Oh shit. Bro. If only I didn't glitch to my own death.
But not like this. The violence. Storyteller who is out to torment and destroy his protagonist.
Oh no. Did I get them all? I think I got them all. So possessed are like the furniture that's possessed or appliances. The fuck out of here, bro. Okay, we're gonna try not to fucking glitch out again here. That was super annoying. Oh god.
Okay, this is just too... You're weird.
Thanks, buddy.
Is all this really coming out of my head?
That's just the way this place is, Al. All that random stuff in your head?
God. They're still chasing me. Oh, Jesus. Ooh. Get fucked, loser. Where we're supposed to be going? Guess so.
You need to get that door open before you can get into the warehouse. That's the way forward!
If I'm making this up, why is it so complicated?
Because you're a complicated man, and no one understands you. But I'm talking...
Mary.
More driving. I still haven't... Oh god. Still haven't changed the controls. Oh god. Okay. Oh no. Bro, I dodged. Come on. You can do it. You missed me, bitch. Oh, shit. It flipped. That's amazing. I win. Yes, that was super cheap. No, I don't fucking care. I'm gonna keep the same, shotgun that I have. Oh god. There's gonna be even more guys. Oh god. Oh shit, man. Oh god. Oof. Oh, you want some too? There are so many fucking guys in the DLC. Hunting rifle? We go with a hunting rifle? I think I will. Although it's only got 5 rounds. Actually, I'm gonna keep the shotgun. That's smarter. And more shotgun ammo there.
Hey, what are you up to? I thought this was my side of the bed.
Okay.
He entered the trap.
Oh, gross. Lovely.
I have nowhere to run. I'm so sick of you.
That was not so bad. We played that fairly well. Climb. Climb faster, Alan. Do I hear somebody? Heavy duty lantern. Dang. Lovely. It's a chainsaw. Oh, Jesus. You missed me, bitch. Good, because I almost got stuck on the edge over there. That would have been really bad. I've been trapped in the corner with fucking Leatherface. TikTok. Your fucking door in. Oh, hello there. Bruh. Lots of explosive containers in here. Oh shit. Ah shit balls. I dropped the flare. Yeah, drop the fucking flare. Not cool, man. Not fucking cool. Oh. you motherfucker. Where'd the other guy go? Just fell back there? He's coming!
Even really there.
Well, my allergies are definitely. See? Allergies.
I actually thought that was a bad guy. A big battery pack there. That was a lot of fucking explosions. God damn. And then there were none.
Downstairs. We don't have time for Alan.
Oh.
I knew she wasn't really here, but she still made my heart ache. I had saved Alice, but I wasn't even sure when that happened. Was it days ago? Weeks? Longer? I had no way of knowing.
Alice, the nyctophobic beauty with muse, horrific booty, the soothing oasis in a seething crisis. The renowned and award-winning photographer's new coffee table book features intensely personal and intimate images from a life haunted by a husband who was never there. Writer's muse. Pre-orders accepted now. Can I even climb this thing? Okay, but how do I get up here in the first place? I'm supposed to push this thing down? Oh yeah, there we go. I mean, it's not that fast. Oh, fuck.
Crazy dangerous.
No, no, it's fun. Don't worry about it, Barry. Oh, God. Oh, fuck. I keep forgetting I don't have the pump. It's only two rounds. 6 shots instead of 2.
Hey, lover. Come here. I've got something for you.
I could only hope that Alice was all right. I didn't know what happened to her after she left the dark place.
Zane? Is that you?
Oh god, am I supposed to drop in this motherfucker? Listen, so... Oh, owie.
Hey, hold that pose. That was a good one.
Like this?
Yeah, but smile a little more. No, that's too much. You want to look mysterious, maybe a little tough. You know how people go for those dangerous bad boys.
But I'm not dangerous.
Oh, come on. You write about terrible things all the time. People want to think that you're intimately familiar with them. You kill Casey in this book. You need to look a little bit like a murderer.
Oh, I am a fucking murderer. Again.
You look handsome.
Blah.
And dangerous.
You know, I wasn't sure about the beard before, but I was wrong. It looks good on you. Okay,
I'm just gonna take pictures of my butthole and sell them on OnlyFans.
Hey, things are looking up.
Oh, God.
Guess danger is sexy.
What is this? Some loud-ass alarm clocks. Sheesh. We're already maxed out on the batteries. What's up, Tom?
Alan, you made it. This area of the dark place is calmer, at least for the time being. We can talk here, but we don't have much time.
Zane, how do I get out of here?
That's what you face. That's you, even as we speak.
Darkness. Darkness coming! Swept him away. Lost! He knew. He knew! He couldn't hold on. He knew there was no way out. Oh,
no, I'm right here, Zane. That's not me. It's
wrong.
Just, I don't know, an echo, a hallucination.
You're trapped somewhere.
The dark presence is not responsible for this. You are making this happen. You're trapped in your own nightmares. You are fighting yourself.
Oh shit.
Wake didn't understand it. He would never make it. He would never wake up. He'd get swallowed up in the rising tide of darkness. It was coming. It was coming.
Shut up!
Uh-oh.
No, Alan, you mustn't.
Swept away by the gathering insanity. Zane was gone. Wake could feel the pressure, gnawing at his mind. The darkness wasn't so bad. It was in him. He felt it. He knew the voice spoke the truth. It was just too hard to think. He can't. Couldn't make sense of it. Couldn't. He wanted to go with the flow. Stop thinking and just... let go.
Oh boy. Fatality. Destroy the TVs. We did that. We did that, didn't we? Why does it still say destroy the TVs? Are there more TVs to destroy? Oh, there are. Okay. Oh, shit. Gonna knock shit over on me. Bruh. We are pretty limited as to what we have for weapons. So that's super cool that they deals health damage. Oh shit. I'm stuck. Please help me. Help me, Lord. Ah, bro. Yo. Chill out, bro. Shit.
He knew he could just let go. Succumb. A part of him had already done it. It was over. It was finished. It was done.
Oh shit. Okay, now that I'm not fucking dead. God, I'm all out of flares.
He couldn't even understand what he was facing.
Ooh. That was pretty intense. My butthole's clenched the whole time. Gotta go, loot some of these goodies. Oh, Lord. What is happening here? Drop the fucking flare, dude. Jesus. That was ridiculous. Camera was getting all fucked up there. Couldn't even see what was happening. Uh-oh.
There you go, Alan.
Hartman.
It's all in your head. You've been making it up.
No.
Really, Wade.
Really, Wade.
Come on. Your delusions. Your delusions.
Back at the lodge.
Why is this happening to me? Why is this happening to me?
You're suffering a mental break, dude. To be continued. All right. End of special feature one. All right. So that is the Signal DLC. So there's only one more DLC that actually involves this, the main storyline. And that is, what is it called now? The Writer. So there is, I believe it's called American Nightmare, is another DLC where I think Alan Wake writes an action book, but, I've heard it's pretty terrible and I don't think it's included. So anyways, in the next episode, we are going to complete the, DLC number two, The Writer. Thank you so much as always, guys. I appreciate your support. Please make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed the DLC video and let me know in the comment section. And hit subscribe so you don't miss out on any future episodes. And we've got a lot of content coming, a lot of giveaways. Make sure to subscribe. You'll automatically be entered so long as your subscription privacy settings are set to public so I can see that you're subscribed. And yeah, as always, guys, I'll look forward to seeing you in the next one.